Break time now. Just like there are jokes about Sardarjis and Pathans and escorts and so on, so one category of jokes is about husband and wife and marriage and wedding and so on. It's just a joke. I mean, you know, the reality is, you know, that people who have not been married are very excited about getting married and they work for it and so on. And if you talk to senior people who have been married for some time, they always make jokes about it and that, you see, our earlier life was nice and so on. Of course, it's not really true. I mean, the truth of the matter is that marriage is a very serious thing. Your life is complete after you get married and so on. But jokes are jokes. So people were there in a bank. There are different lines for different tellers, right? Cashiers and so on. Three, four, five people enter the bank. They are wearing masks. Their faces are covered. They have guns in their hand. They close all the doors. They fire one or two extra fires and then tell everybody that, you see, nobody will move, nobody will talk, nobody will do anything. And some of them went to the cashiers and started taking the money. One of them was roaming around looking at everybody, that nobody is doing anything and so on. By mistake, his mask slipped a little on his face, so his face can be seen now. He realized it and he quickly put the face mask back on. But the person, the customer who was standing close to him, line, he turned to him and said, "Did you see my face? Did you see my face?" Now that person is quite intelligent. He knows that, you see, if I say, "Yes, I saw your face," then I'll be able to recognize this guy. So maybe he'll have to kill me before they leave. So he said, no. "No, mister, I have never seen you. I have not seen your face. But you see, my wife is standing beside me. She has seen your face." Joke is over. So we were showing you this table of standard BCC crystal structure metals, right? Some famous metals which are used in engineering. And then the experimentally measured value of the lattice constant A and the atomic radius R, both in nanometers. And of course, the controlling equation, root 3A is equal to 4R, right? So this equation is there. Now to your favorite activity, solving some examples. Calculate the lattice constant A for iron. So now, as I always tell you, that you see, whenever you reach this stage, please pause the lecture, open your notebook blank, take your pen and pencil, write the knowns, write the unknowns. You can go back into the slides to see any table, to see any equation, but you should not go forward. If you do it this way and solve every problem yourself, then you will be pretty strong. So calculate the lattice constant A for iron. Pause it, solve it. It will take 2-3 minutes, and then come back and unpause it. So if you go to the previous tables, right, this is one thing, right? It is the equation. The equation for BCC, iron is BCC. So the equation is root 3A is equal to 4R. And in the table, the value of the radius of iron is given. The lattice constant A, you cannot take from the table. You calculate it from this equation. And once you find this answer, then you compare that, is it close to it or not. So at room temperature, the atomic radius is 0.124 from the table. A is equal to 4R upon root 3. You put the value, you get 0.2864 nanometer. 0.2864 nanometers. Now you compare that, is this value close to the value given in the table. You will find that it is very close. It is already a fraction of a nanometer, and it is accurate to about 1,000th of a nanometer. So this thing, when you go to the table, will be unimaginable. That, you see, we developed a theory. Apparently, it's a very simple theory, but there were two things which did not make a lot of sense originally. That every atom is a solid round sphere, because we know that there are empty spaces between them, and that every atom actually touches the other atom. But based on this theory, when you developed an equation, then in that equation, you put the value of R experimentally found from atomic theory, then the value of lattice constant that you found by calculation, by theory, is very, very, very close to the value that is there in the experiment. Okay. Calculate the atomic packing factor for BCC unit cell based on hard sphere assumption. So now they are not saying which material. They are not saying which material, general BCC. So again, pause, open a page, write down the problem, knowns and unknowns. It is atomic packing factor. So you go back and look at the definition of atomic packing factor, right? So first, please go there into your page, take 2-3 minutes, solve it completely, be very sure. And now it is atomic packing factor. So please see what the unit will be and so on. Units are always very critical. Once you have done it yourself, then unpause the lecture. And so the definition of the atomic packing factor is volume of atoms in a unit cell divided by the volume of the unit cell. So simplest is volume of the unit cell. What is volume of the unit cell? It is a cube. Each side is A. So A cubed is the volume of the unit cell. What is the volume of one atom? 4 by 3 pi r cubed. How many atoms are there in BCC? 2. So in the numerator, you have 2 multiplied by 4 by 3 pi r cubed. And in the denominator, you have A. Now, how to cancel out some things? Think. Is there any equation, other equation that you know? Yes. One equation is this atomic packing factor equation. What is the other equation? 4r is equal to root 3a and something. So from there, either say r is equal to so much a, or say a is equal to so much r. And now in the denominator and the numerator, top and bottom, either you have a and a here, or you have r and r here, and you try to cancel out and see. So yes, volume of the atoms, 2 atoms, 4 by 3 pi r cubed. So you, whatever number it is. For BCC, A is equal to 4r by root 3. A is equal to 4r by root 3 for BCC, right? So again, something r. Volume of a unit cell is A cubed. So A is how much in terms of r? So put that r and so much cubed. So now you have volume of unit cell. So volume of atoms upon volume of unit cell. Volume of atoms is this much, and volume of unit cell is this much. This number upon this number, r cubed cancel out. It comes out to be 0.68. Remember, when we were doing the lecture a few slides back, right? So I was just saying that we found in the lectures that for BCC, the atomic packing factor is 0.68 or 68%. At that time, a few slides ago, we were talking about it, that this is something which is given to you. But now, based on the basic simple theory, and now the two equations, that atomic packing factor, this is the definition, and the relationship between A and R for BCC is this. So you just substitute it, and you yourself have found now that the atomic packing factor for BCC, any BCC, is 0.68. Because this R cubed and this R cubed cancel away, so whether it was iron or chromium or any other material, the atomic packing factor for BCC metals is 0.68. With this, we finish the first structure. We told you that BCC, body-centered cubic, FCC, face-centered cubic, and HCP, hexagonal close-packed, together, they cover more than 90% of the world materials. So now, if you see the heading, we go to the next one. Face-centered cubic. Face-centered cubic. So again, let me go to the next page. Here we are telling you that the atomic packing factor is 0.74. This is more closely packed than BCC. BCC was 0.68. So here 74% of the atom of the unit cell is packed with atoms, right? And then the coordination number here is 12. Coordination number is 12. And there will be 4 atoms per unit cell and so on. So let us see. This is just a repeat of the same slide. So I am sorry. But this is now the geometrical representation, the schematic diagram and so on. So we know that we have a simple cube. Simple cube means 4 on the top corners, 4 on the bottom corners, and then 1 in the center of each face. So 6 extra. But this is for us to explain. But for the theory that all atoms should touch each other. So this should be made until the center here, this should be made until the center here. So this is what we are doing. If you see, this one is touching this one, and this one is trying to touch that one, and so on, right? But maybe they cannot touch completely. Maybe they cannot, but on one face, this central one will be on a face. And then there will be this one, and this one, and this one, and this one. So the central one on one face will touch all the four corner atoms. So like this, that if this is the center one, then it is touching the four corner atoms. And just like earlier, once we draw all of them, then we section each face. We section on this face, on this face, on this face, and so forth. So once again, we will see that the corner atoms, because you have sectioned in a cubic manner, so the corner atoms will still be 1 by 8. The corner atoms will still be 1 by 8. So there are 8 corner atoms, 4 at the top, 4 at the bottom, 8 times 1 by 8. And how many face atoms are there? 6 faces, so 6 face atoms. But each face atom, the way it is cut, it is half. So 6 into half. So how many do you have? 6 into half is 3. And 8 into 1 by 8 is 1. So total 4 equivalent atoms. So this is much heavier, right? Much more closely packed, because in a BCC, there were 2 equivalent atoms in the unit cell. Here in the FCC, there are 3 plus 1, 4 equivalent atoms, right? So now the other things, that the coordination number has been told, the atomic packing factor is there. So you can now calculate all the things. You can calculate the atomic packing factor once again, but this time the equation will have to be different. So before we go to the atomic packing factor, that equation between A and R, right? That equation between A is the lattice constant. A is the lattice constant. Length of this side, or length of this side, or length of this side, whatever, they are all A. And capital R is the radius of this atom. So now again, pause the lecture. Pause the lecture, take your pen and pencil, draw this. Again, draw this. Make a cube. In that cube, you are showing some atoms. Now again, try to go to a figure where atoms are touching each other. Remember, in the body-centered cubic, we drew a diagonal from bottom to top, diagonal, on which the atoms were touching each other. So here in this figure, from A, B, C, whichever figure you like, you think, what part of the diagram should I take so that the atoms are touching each other? Do that, and then simple Pythagoras theorem, simple geometry, and come up with the relationship of A and R. Please stop my lecture, pause it, do it. It will take 2, 3, 4 minutes, 5 minutes, but do not give up. Do not give up. You see, it is not material science. It is simple geometry now, and a very simple geometry. So do not give up. Unless you are done, don't come back to the lecture. Be very sure. And whatever your result is, look at it and be sure about your result. So, okay, now I think you have done it. So let us, we are showing you here, but let me go to a figure. Let me go to a figure. A figure is right. So we are, you see, now rather than going to the body, we can look at any one face, because this atom is touching this corner and this corner, any one face. So this is R, 2R and R. So the length of this line is 4R. And now this is any one face. So this is A, this is A. So this is root 2A. Remember, A squared plus A squared under root 2A. So this is much simpler than the body centered, because in body centered, you are going from one corner to the other top corner. Here you are only on one face. So 4R is equal to root 2A. So this is your equation, right? So as simply as this, you have defined now the lattice constant 2 atom radius equation for the FCC unit cell.